Well, I'm standing here by the door of the house where I was born and where my father was born in 1901, my grandfather in 1874, my great-grandfather in 1841, and my great-great-grandmother probably about 1810. So the house is quite old. It hasn't been used as a dwelling place since 1958. When we moved 30 feet from this door to a new house. I think that, like, if I had a dream that could be realized for Camden, I would want every child to have a house that they came home to and they would love it. A house when they come to the door, like the door was the entrance to the, I don't know, like the temple of your life, where your life is lived, and you never get a day back. You never get the day back. You never get the year back. You never, like, time is so special or something. You kind of want to feel its meaning and the pace of time and the special time, and not be in a mad rush, but feel that place. I'd want them to have a lovely, not a big house, but a nice house. And I'd want them, when they walked out the door, that the next house was nice, and there was flowers, and there was a window boxes. And you don't have to have a lot of land to make something look good. And I'd want everybody to have one goal in life, to create beauty. I would want them all to be doing that. And to know that a child, that innocent, untouched space, maybe space isn't the right word, but whatever, that inside, like, ocean of imagination, that inside, what's in there so innocent and untrampled and undamaged, and that beauty would come through the, as we say, the windows of the soul into that sacred area. And if that happened, it would kill anger and it would kill violence. It would, because you'd be walking around with a sense of it. And no wonder people get violent if they've been abused and all sorts of ugliness has crashed through their sacred windows and into themselves. Like, I feel that a lot.
I see trees of green, red roses too. I see them bloom for me and you. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I see skies of blue, clouds of white, the bright blessed day, the dark sacred night, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world.
I have a great dream of restoration and people doing it, and And seeing that in the house that's restored, a restored self. If you restore a house, you are actually restoring people. You are transforming something that was damaged into something that was full of life and light and hope. And it's here waiting, calling, crying for restoration. And this nation has the money, first of all. It has the ingenuity. And it has the generosity. It just needs that to know about it. And to know that if you restore a place like Waterfront South, the south of Camden, here, you're restoring America.
And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. The colors of the rainbow, so pretty in the sky, are also on the faces of people going by. I see friends shaking hands, saying, how do you do? They're really saying, I love you. I hear babies cry, I watch them grow. Like much more than I never knew. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. Yes, I think to myself, what a wonderful world.